愿大家平安。
Peace to everyone.
下午我们继续来早上的主题，最奇妙的书。
And this afternoon, we're going to continue the same topic from the morning, that is the most wonderful book.
只有一本书可以经得起所有时间的考验。
And there is only one book that can withstand the test of time.
只有一本书可以改变人的生命。
And only one book that can transform and change one person's life.
这本书就是圣经。
And this book is the Holy Bible.
因为圣经本身就是神的生命。
Because the Holy Bible itself, it is the life of God.
因为圣经说神就是道。
Because the Bible says that the Word is life.
所以我们要学习圣经。
And because God is the Word, that is why we need to study the Bible.
我们再看看第三页的这个信条，第信条的第二条，我们信圣经。
And so let's look at this article, the second article of faith, and that is to believe in the Holy Bible.
我们再一起把它读一遍。
Let's all read it together.
一二三，信新旧约圣经是神所默示，为证明正道为一致根据及信徒生活之准则。我们早上有介绍过什么叫旧约，什么叫新约。
And this morning we have introduced the Old and the New Testament.
还有旧约、新约、圣经六十六卷怎么样的组成。
And also how the Old and New Testament, all 66 books, how they were canonized.
也有讲到有关于圣经并没有在久远的年代当中的翻译当中流失，它的准确度是可以信的。
And we can also believe in the accuracy of the Bible translation that there is no loss in translation over the years.
让我们看到死海古卷的发现，证明我们现在用的圣经跟几千年前神启示先知写下来的是一样的。
And also the great archaeological discovery of the Dead Sea Scrolls serves to prove that the Bible is accurate.
那我们有讲到过，圣经是神所默示的。
And we've also mentioned that the Holy Spirit. The Holy Bible is being breathed out by the Spirit of God.
这句话很特别，我们再读一次。
And this verse is very unique. Let's read it all together.
提摩太后书三章十六节。
Let's all turn to 2 Timothy chapter 3.
三章十六节。
2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 16.
我们一起读，一二三。
Let's read it together.
圣经都是神所默示的。于教训读者使人归正教导人学义都是有益的。这里说圣经神所默示的。
So over here it says that the scripture is given by the inspiration of God.
下一页了已经好 page 28。所谓的默示这是神吹气的意思。
So here the word inspiration means that it is breathed out.
圣经是神吹气出来产生的。
And that is to say the Bible is being breathed out by God.
那到底神吹什么出来？
So what did God breathe out?
神造亚当的时候把他造好了，但是他却死翘翘的躺在那边。
And when God created Adam, he was just made of dust and he is just a dead dust.
但是神对他的鼻孔吹了一口气。
But yet God breathed into the nostril of Adam.
这一口气叫做生气，就是生命的气息。
And that this breath is the breath of life.
他就活过来了。
And then Adam, the dust being, grew out of the dust.
不但肉体活过来。
Not just did his physical being become alive.
还有神的生命在他里面。
He also had the life of God inside him.
所以这口气也代表神的生命。
So therefore, this breath is the breath of God.
那些文字也是一样，文字本来是死的。
So in the same way, these words, black and white on the paper, it is also dead.
但是神给他们吹气了。
But God has breathed out his life.
用他的灵感动了先知，把他的话写下来。
And God, he inspired all the writers by his word.
所以这些字就不是平面的，不是在纸上面的而已。
And that is why these words are not just black and white on paper.
它是立体的。
But it becomes three-dimensional.
不单只是三度空间，甚至是四度空间呢。
It's not just three-dimensional, but it's also four-dimensional.
超过时间的。
And that is, it's going beyond time.
可以进到你的生命里面。
It can enter into your life.
还有呢，第十七节说可以改变你的生命，可以让你成为完全。
And then verse 17, it says that the man of God can be complete, thoroughly equipped for every good work.
你看第十七节哦，叫属神的人得以完全。
Here, verse 17 says that the man of God, those who belong to God, may become complete.
什么叫属神？
What does it mean to belong to God?
你受洗你就属神了。
Because after you have been baptized, you belong to God.
但是你受洗就完全吗？
But after you have been baptized, does that mean that you're perfect?
我们很多行为都不完全。
Many of our ways and conduct are not perfect.
所以要常常读圣经啊。
So that is why we need to always study the Bible.
你一读圣经的时候，
Because when you study the Bible,
神就好像对你吹气一样。
Then it's like you're allowing God's breath to enter into your being.
你就好像那个躺在地上死的亚当一样。
And you are just like Adam, just a piece of dust lying on the ground.
但是如果神的话语进来了，
But once the word of God entered into you,
神的生命进来了，
The life of God entered into you,
你就可以站起来，可以活着，可以行各样的善事。
Then you can stand up, you can be alive again, doing all good work.
可以按着神的生命， 按照神的旨意去生活。
And that you can live according to the will of God.
所以啊， 神怎么对你吹气？
So then the question is, how does God breathe out his life unto you?
你读圣经的时候， 神就对你吹气啊。
When you read and study the Bible, that is the time when God is breathing his life into you.
我们看这个约翰福音第六章，
Let's all turn to the book of John.
63节，
Gospel of John chapter 6.
约翰六章六十三节，
Gospel of John chapter 6 verse 63.
这句也是很重要。
This is also a very important verse.
大声一起读啊。
Let's read it out loud together.
一二三， 叫人活着的乃是灵， 肉体是无益的， 我对你们所说的话， 就是灵， 就是生命。 所以说这里讲出一个灵界的现实。
So over here, Lord Jesus points out the reality of the spiritual realm.
是什么东西让你活着的？
What is this one thing that allows you to live?
叫人活着的不是肉体。
So it is not the flesh that allows you to be alive.
你以为说我吃东西，我喝水，我吃维他命，我就活着了吗？
So do you think that you just eat, you drink, you take vitamins, and then you're alive?
你每天运动，拍打，捏这里，吹哪里，你就可以活很久吗？
And that every day you go out for your exercise and then you massage here and there, you think you can be alive?
其实你今天可以活着，是因为你的灵魂还在里面。
The fact that today you can still be alive, it is because your spirit and soul is still dwelling inside you.
如果神把你的灵拿走了，
But if God take away your spirit,
就算你吃得太好，你每天运动，你还是马上失去生命。
Doesn't matter how well you take care of yourself, you will still lose life at that moment.
更重要的，叫我们 活着的是神的灵啊。
And what is most important is that when we are alive, the Spirit of God lives inside us.
这个是灵命啊。
And this is a spiritual life.
怎么样让这个灵命一直活着？
So how do we allow our spiritual life to thrive?
耶稣说的，我对你们所说的话就是灵。
Lord Jesus says here that the words that I speak to you are spirit.
这句话很重要哦。
This is a very important verse.
我对你们所说的话。
He says that these are the words that I speak to you.
这个不是只有旧约而已了。
It is not just in the Old Testament.
早上我们讲了六章三十九节，
and this,
五章三十九节。
And this morning we talk about chapter 5 verse 39.
约翰五章三十九节。
And John 5:39.
这里主耶稣说，你们查考圣经，叫你们，因为你们 以为内中有永生。
So over here it says that you search the scriptures, for in them you think that you have eternal life.
耶稣说你们查考圣经，这个圣经是指旧约圣经。
So when Jesus mentioned over here, Lord Jesus referred the scriptures as Old Testament.
因为旧约圣经是预言耶稣要来啊，里面当然有生命啊。
Because the Old Testament is going to prophesy the coming of Jesus Christ, of course there is life.
但是旧约圣经还不够。
But the Old Testament is not enough.
耶稣说，我对你们所说的话啊，这新约了。
And then Jesus says that the words that I speak to you, this refer to the New Testament.
六章六十三节说，我对你们所说的话就是灵啊。
Then that turns back us back to John 6:63. These are the words that I speak to you, and it is life.
就是生命。
They are life.
所以原来新约圣经主耶稣所说的话也是生命，也是灵。
So that tells us that the New Testament are the words spoken by Lord Jesus. They are also the words of life.
所以你们坐在这边，如果你这边打瞌睡，生命就进不去了。
So therefore, today if you're sitting over here, you're dozing off, life cannot enter into you.
你在玩手机，神的话出来，你也进不去了。
And if you're serving on the phone, and even if you're hearing the words of God, it cannot enter into your heart.
你在外游太空，你想外面的事，神的灵也进不去了。
And if your mind is wandering in outer space, of course the word of God cannot enter into your heart.
或者听了也不要改，神的灵当然就神的生命就进不去了。
And also maybe you hear the words of God in one ear and it's out in the other, you won't transform.
所以你不要少看在聚会的时候。
So therefore, do not belittle this time of worship.
不要少看你在家里打开圣经的时候。
So don't belittle the time, the quiet time of Bible study at home.
神的话语，你打开，你接受了。
Because when you open up the words of God, you will receive life.
就是灵，就是生命。
And it is the spirit, it is life.
所以你可以看到啊，神对亚当吹气是个灵嘛，对不对
？So therefore, when we see how God breathed out life into Adam, he became alive.
因为个灵，神的灵。
And that is because of the spirit of God.
今天神的灵也透过他的话语给我们。
Today, in the same way, through the words of God, the Holy Spirit will enter into our heart.
因为耶稣说，我跟你说的话就是灵。
Because Jesus says over here, the words that I speak to you, it is spirit, it is life.
所以你今天领受什么？
So today, what are you receiving?
如果我们常常领受神的话,
so if we always receive the words of God,
你的生命, 灵命一定是坚强, 一定是长进的,
then your spiritual life will definitely be strong and it will definitely be abundant.
但是很可惜, 今天我们领受世界的东西远远超过我们领受神的话。
But today it is very sad because we have received much more from the media and from the world outside than the word of God.
看下一个图啊。
And let's look at the next screen.
是我找到一个图，非常要讽刺性很大。
And I found this picture that is very sarcastic.
现在有电脑，有无限的网络，有无限的资讯。
And because now we have the internet, it allows us limited access to all the information out there.
从醒过来第一刻，我们就摸我的手机了。
From the moment we wake up, we touch our phone.
睡觉之前最后一秒钟也可能在摸手机。
And before we go to bed, we are still hanging on to our electronic devices.
我们接受这个世界给我们什么？
So what are we receiving from all the stuff out there?
可以说大部分，绝大部分都是垃圾。
And we can say that majority of the content, they are garbage.
当然有一些是新闻啊，资讯啊，是有用的。
Of course, some of them contain the news, and they may be also useful.
但是我们大部分的东西，喜爱看的东西，大部分是没有什么价值。
But most of the things that we like to watch, they are of little or no value.
垃圾有两个特质。
And there are two characteristics of garbage.
第一就是占空间。
And first, they take up space.
你有垃圾在，你的位置就没有了。
If you have garbage over here, then the space is gone.
你心中充满的垃圾，那你给神的空间你就没有了。
So in the same way, if your heart is full of the garbage of the world, you have no space left for God.
为什么现在的人打开圣经读不下去？
Why is it that today people have no patience in reading the Bible when they open it up?
听道理，听一下下就觉得很无聊。
And when they listen to the sermon, they find it so boring.
因为心中已经没空间了。
Because why? They have no space in their heart left for God.
神的话怎么进去？
So how can the word of God enter into their heart?
垃圾有第二个特性，就是脏。
And the second characteristic of garbage is that it is filthy.
今天很多东西我们外面接受的资讯都会弄脏我们的心灵。
And also today, a lot of the information and the stuff that we got from the world outside, they will make our heart filthy.
今天我们的心很脏。
Today our heart is very defiled.
充满不好的欲望。
It is full of filthy desires.
充满仇恨，充满愤怒。
Full of hatred, full of anger.
因为我们被垃圾充满了。
Because our heart is being filled with all kinds of garbage.
如果领受垃圾，你就变成垃圾。
So if you receive garbage, you will turn out to become a garbage yourself.
领受神的灵，领受神的话，你就变成越来越像神。
But if you, on the other hand, receive the word of God, receive the spirit of God, then you will become a spiritual person.
好，那我们再来看这个圣经啊，是我们信仰唯一的根据。
And next, let's look at the Bible as the foundation of our faith.
Only scriptural truth.
The Bible is the only scriptural truth.
不是其中之一的根据，是唯一的根据。
It's not one of the truth, but it is the only scriptural absolute truth.
两个礼拜之前我们讲了独一真神。
And two weeks ago, we talked about the only one true God.
神是独一的，就是唯一的意思。
And our God is only one. That is his absolutely one.
如果你相信真神耶稣基督，你就不会相信别的神，别的就不是神。
That is to say, if you believe in the one true God who is Jesus Christ, you won't believe in any other gods.
那如果你相信圣经，它是唯一的。
So if you believe the Holy Bible as the only scriptural truth,
就没有别的书可以跟它同等。
That is to say, it will be far above all other kinds of books. None of them can compare.
你也不可以更改它。
You cannot change.
这个就是唯一的意思。
That means it's absolute.
对不起啊，很多现在的人不喜欢唯一这个字。
And it is true that today many people out there, they don't like to hear the word absolute.
因为人觉得说, 为什么要逼我们介绍唯一的东西?
Because people will think that, why are you forcing me to accept this one absolute truth?
现在有多元文化, 多元的这种,
That is to say, our mind must be open to diversity of different truths out there.
但是神的话没有多元的。
But our God's words is not of diversity.
神的救恩也不是多重选择。
And also the salvation of God is not a choice out of the different diversity of faith.
你只是选择要还是不要。
It's either you choose yes or no.
你要的话就要跟着神的标准去走。
So if you say yes to God, then you have to follow his path.
所以圣经的真理是绝对的。
So that is to say, the truth of the Bible, it is absolute.
不可以增加, 不可以更改。
You cannot add to it, you cannot change the words of God. Let's all turn to the book of Galatians chapter
1.
Galatians chapter 1, verse 6 to 8.
加拉太书一章的六节到八节。
Galatians 1, 6 to 8. Galatians 1, verse 6. I marvel that you are turning away so soon from him who called you in the grace of Christ to a different gospel.
第七节,
verse 7, which is not another, but there are some who trouble you and want to pervert the gospel of Christ.
第八节,
verse 8, but even if we or an angel from heaven preach any other gospel to you than what we have preached to you, let him be accursed.
我们基督徒啊,不应该随便咒诅别人,这个我们都知道了。
So as Christians, we know that we should not curse other people.
但是保罗说,在一种情况之下,你可以咒诅人。
But Paul says over here that under one condition, you can curse the other person.
就是那个人是应该被咒诅人。
And because that person, he is worthy to be accursed.
什么情况之下?
And what is this kind of situation?
这个人无论是使徒, 传道, 长职, 或者是天使都好啊。
So it doesn't matter whether this person, he is a minister, a worker of God, or even an angel.
如果他来跟你传另外一个福音,
if he come and preach to you a different gospel,
跟你之前领受的不一样,
and it is different from what you have prior received,
比如说他以前告诉你要守安息日,
for example, before he tell you to observe the Sabbath,
啊,你领受了,
and then now you have received this Sabbath truth,
现在他告诉你说, 其实不一定礼拜六安息日,星期天也可以。
But now, on the other hand, he turned around and says that, well, it is okay, you can also worship on Sunday.
那他就是传一个你跟你领受的不一样呢?
So that means now he is preaching a different gospel from what you have already received.
哦, 那保罗说了,
so then Paul says that this person should be accursed.
为什么那么严重呢?
Why is it so serious?
你想想看,如果有人把毒放在你的食物里面让你吃了, 拉肚子, 甚至生病, 甚至死了, 这个人可不可恶?
So think about it. If someone were to put poison into your food and you have diarrhea and you almost go to the hospital, isn't this person an evil person?
当然你会咒诅他。
Of course you will curse this person to death.
你怎么害死我啊?
Because why are you bringing death upon me?
如果放毒在你食物当中, 你顶多 肉体死了,那你灵魂可以上天堂啊?
So if the poison is in your food, found in your food, you may eat it and die, but well, at least your body is dead, you can still have a chance to go to heaven.
但是如果有人把一些假道传给你,
but yet, if someone were to give you a false gospel,
这是更改了原来福音的内容,
a perverted gospel from the original scriptural truth,
更改了这个教义,
and it has been perverted the articles of faith,
那你相信呢?
Then now you believe, and now you believe in a false gospel that prevented you from entering into heaven. So this person is bringing death upon you, bringing you down to hell. So if the whole family were to follow this person, then the whole family will go to hell as well. So isn't this person an evil person? And that's the situation in the church of Galatia at that time.
就是有人混乱的圣经的道理,混乱的教义,真道。
And that is to say that someone has come and pervert the gospel.
哎呀, 所以保罗说啊, 不要跟随他们了。
So Paul, he warned them not to follow this antichrist.
那如果有人说了, 哎呀, 我昨天晚上啊, 神给我报一个梦哦, 告诉我一些不一样的真理。
And then someone come and tell you, you know, God has given me a very special dream last night.
神跟我讲的, 神启示我的。
God has given me a special revelation.
因为你听到, 哇, 启示那么重要啊, 他也有启示耶, 怎么办?
Then you heard that, wow, the revelation is so miraculous. This person also got revelation from God.
哎, 我们不要被骗。
So be careful, do not be deceived.
我们看启示录第二十二章。
Let's turn to Revelation 22.
二十二章的十八节。
Revelation 22.
十八节
，verse 18。
启示录二十二章十八节
，Revelation 22 verse 18。
十八十九节，这一节这两节很重要，大家一起大声读。
Verse 18 and 19, let's read it out loud。
坐直一点，大声读就会提起精神啊。
Let's sit up straight and read it out loud。
一二三，我向一切听见这树上预言的做见证。若有人在这预言上加添什么？神必将写在这树上的灾祸加在他身上。十九节。这树上的预言，若有人撇弃什么，神必从这使这树上的生命树和圣城删去他的份。阿门。这里是警告我们，圣经非常的严肃。
So over here, the Bible gave us a very serious warning.
神的启示到启示录这边就没有了，最后了。
Because God's revelation has come to a conclusion in this book of Revelation.
如果你再在启示录之外，整个圣经到这里结束了，神的启示结束了之后，你再加东西进去。
And that is to say, upon the last book, the final book of the book of Revelation, you still add an extra book on top of it.
这神就把灾祸加在你身上。
Then here it says that God will add to that person plagues that are written in this book.
圣经没有的东西啊。
And that is to say the truth that is outside of the Bible.
譬如说，圣经没有说要庆祝圣诞，你就加一个庆祝圣诞上去。
So take for example, the Bible never tell you to celebrate Christmas, and you add Christmas celebration on top.
没有叫你庆祝复活，你就加一个庆祝复活。
And the Bible never tell you to observe Easter, and now you celebrate Easter.
没有叫你庆祝这个星期天当主日，你也加进去。
And the Bible never tell you to worship God on Sunday, which is the Lord's day. They say,
你说哦，这个是神的启示，这个是神告诉我要做的。
And then here you claim that this is revelation from God. God revealed it to me.
不行啊，不可以加的。
You cannot do that because you cannot add to God's word.
有一些教派呢，他除了圣经之外呢，还用别的经书来作为他们信仰的标准。
And then there are some churches, some Christian denomination other than the Bible, they also have other apocrypha.
比如说摩门教。
Take for example the Mormon church.
除了圣经之外，他们说。我们的摩门经啊，也是神启示的，跟圣经的同等的地位。
And other than the Holy Bible, they say that we also have the Book of Mormon, the same level status as the Holy Bible.
这是他们的信仰。
That is what they believe.
但是我们的信仰就只有圣经，唯一圣经。
But our faith, what we believe that only the Bible is the absolute truth.
不可以增加圣经以外的东西。
You cannot add any other perverted gospel onto it.
那也不可以从原有东西拿走啊。
And you cannot also remove any truth from the Bible.
譬如说圣经里面有守安息生日。
So take for example, the Bible tells us to worship God on the Sabbath day.
但是大部分的基督徒就把这一条拿走了。
But most Christian denominations, they take away Sabbath worship.
我们不敢。
But then we don't dare to do so.
就算我们不是主流，跟大家不一样。
Yes, we may not be mainstream churches like most of the churches out there.
我们一定要跟着圣经走。
But yet we must obey God and follow the Bible.
不然的话，我们怎么敢跟神交代以后的信仰？以后面对神怎么样可以站得住
？If not, how can we be accountable to God when we face Him in the future?
好，那这个圣经除了是唯一的信仰根据之外
，So yes, the Bible, other than it being the only scriptural truth,
我们也要把它用成为我们生活的准则。
We must also use the Bible as the moral compass of our life.
我们怎么叫做生活的准则
？What does it mean that the Bible is the moral compass of our life?
Standard of Christian living.
As a standard of Christian living.
我们知道什么东西都有标准。
And we know that there's standards to everything.
你开车出去，你就跟着那个线跑，跟着那个红绿灯。
And when you drive, you have to follow all the traffic rules.
你不能说我用我的标准。
You cannot say that I'm using my own rules.
加拿大是车子在开右边嘛，哈。
And in Canada, we drive on the right side of the road.
有一些国家是开左边的。
And some countries, they drive on the left side of the road.
你不能说我在我的国家是开左边的，我来这边也要开左边。
And you cannot claim that, well, from my country, we drive on the right side. So when I visit other country, I will still drive on the right side.
你来这边，你就要跟着这个地方的这个交通规则。
But when you visit the other country, if they drive on the left side, you have to follow along.
那神的话语，神是创造世界的创造者。
And God, He is the creator of the entire universe.
当然, 我们的生活如果要蒙神祝福,
and in the same way, if our life is to be blessed by God, we must follow His rules and regulations.
那怎么样来按照他的生活准则,
so how can we achieve the standard of Christian living?
我们看雅各书第一章,
let's all turn to the book of James.
雅各书第一章22节。
James 1 verse 22.
雅各书第一章22节.
James 1 verse 22.
我们一起来读,
let's read it all together.
雅各书一章22节.
James 1:22.
一二三. 只是你们要行道, 不要单单听道, 自己气哄自己. 23节.
23.
因为听道而不行道的人，就像人对着镜子看着自己本来的面目。 24节， 看见走后，随即忘了他的相貌如何。
What kind of man he was.
这里告诉我们, 听道不行道的人像什么?
So here it says that if you are just a hearer of the word and not a doer of the word,
今天我们不是缺听道。
So today we are not missing hearing the word of God.
今天我们一个礼拜聚会那么多次,
because we have so many services once every week.
网络上面有那么多我们真耶稣教会的讲道, 全世界你要听哪一个传道, 哪一个教会你按全部跑出来。
And you have endless supply of sermons on the internet, any churches around the world.
但是我们缺的是什么?
So what are we lacking?
我们缺的是行道。
We are lacking to become the doer of the word.
听了听了听了，但是都没有行出来。
We can hear so much sermons, but yet we do not practice it.
哇，听了这个人讲爱心了，讲得很好哦，很感动哦。
And then we hear someone who is such a loving person, we are so touched.
旁边那个人需要你帮忙，跌在地上要你扶一下，你都不管，我要去打饭，我要去讲位置。
And then the other person who has fallen down, you don't even take a minute to carry the person up.
有老玩家聚会完，不知道怎么回家，或者是。 缺乏这个交通,
and some elderly members after church service, they may need transportation home.
哎，你看到了，人家需要帮忙，会不会主动去帮忙？
So if you saw their need, would you go ahead and give them a ride?
所以听道跟行道不要把它分开。
So therefore, do not separate the hearing and the doing.
我们今天听太多了。
Today we have heard so much.
但是我们没有做出来。
But we do not practice.
我们就好像那个人照了镜子。
Just like a person who looks into the mirror.
哇，这我头发翘起来了。
Oh, look at my hair is standing up.
哦，胡子也没刮。
And I did not even shave my beard.
啊，脸色又很难看。
And I'm looking so fallen.
又有眼屎，又有鼻屎。
And I did not groom myself.
哎呀，那么难看。好了，走了。
And well, since I look so bad, too bad, I just walk away.
你们那个人好难看哦。 我不喜欢看他走了。
Oh, the person in the mirror looks so bad. I don't like to look at the person. I'm just walking away.
你这样照镜子有用吗?
So what's the point of looking into the mirror then?
我们就是那个人，常常听道理，但是没有改。
So we are that kind of person. We just hear the word, but we don't practice the word.
还有我们都是想帮别人改。
And then we want to help others to change.
这个道理啊，你应该听一下。
And we tell the person, you must listen to this truth.
传道讲你啊，老婆，传道讲你啊。
And you tell your wife, look, the preacher is talking about you.
老公，今天这篇道理我要发给你，你要再听十次。
And then you tell your husband, you know, you should listen to this sermon 10 times.
我们都帮别人听。
So we are helping the other person to hear the truth.
都帮别人照镜子，这个镜子就是你，就是你。
And we are telling the other person, look into the mirror, this is you in the mirror.
其实最丑的，最丑陋的就是我自己。
But actually the most ugly person is you yourself.
只是我们看完就走了，不要越去改。
It's just that we saw ourselves in the mirror, we just walk away.
真的，如果主耶稣把我们真实的属灵形象显给我们看，我们会自己吓死，怎么那么丑？
Because truly, if God were to reveal your most inner spiritual self, you will be so shocked.
但是我们不要这样。
So let us not become like a person.
不要等到审判台前，主耶稣把我们真实面貌再播给我们看。
So don't wait until you are standing on the judgment seat when you face your own true self.
我们要学什么？
What should we learn?
25节。
25.
一起读25节。
Let's read it together.
一二三。 唯有详细查看那全备，使人自由之律法的，并且时常如此，这人既不是听了就忘，乃是实行出来，这在他所行的事上必然得福。常常要看。So
it says over here that you must look at yourself frequently.
生活的准则就是你读完圣经跟自己比较一下。
So when we talk about the standards of Christian living, it is to compare ourselves to the Bible.
就是你开车，我有没有开在别人的线上？我没有压线呢？
And in the same way, when you're driving, are you obeying the rules? Did you go beyond the line?
我没有开在不应该开的地方。
Are you driving in places that you shouldn't drive?
我们通常人都是看到警察车在后面的时候才会想象，哎呀，我好像开太快了。
And sometimes we, when we see a police car tailgating us, then we realize that, oh, we are speeding.
有时候你看到警察车的时候，你才刹车太慢。And
it's too late for you to slam the brakes when you see the police car.
自己要常常看呢，我哪里不对。
So you must always self-reflect as to where you have gone wrong.
那这个是全备的律法，是我们自由的律法。
Because this is the absolute truth, it is most complete, it gives us liberty.
神的话语是全备的，不会缺什么的，缺的是你自己。
Because the word of God is most complete, you are the one who is not complete.
人很奇怪哦，有时候自己做不到，就说神的律法写得太严了。
And sometimes, man, it is very interesting. We cannot achieve it, then we blame it on the law of God.
神绝对不会写一些你做不到的东西给你。
Because remember, God will not give you rules that is beyond your ability.
不要为自己找借口。
So don't find excuses for yourself.
是我们自己懒，自己散。
It is because we are just lazy and slothful.
自己顽固。
We are stubborn.
好，为自己做很多借口，不改。
And then we give ourselves so many excuses and not change.
神是全备的，神的话是全备的，我们是缺乏的。
God's word is complete. We are the one who is lacking.
神的话语也不是绑住你哦。
And the words of God is not to bind you.
有人说，哎呀，当基督徒好可怜。
Some people claim that, oh, it is so sad to become a Christian.
不能抽烟，不能喝酒，不能跳舞，不能看色情，不能做坏事。
I cannot do, you know, all this bad stuff like dancing and drinking and smoking and watching pornography.
啊，不能骗人。
I cannot deceive other people.
有一个慕道者来教会很久。
There is a truth seeker coming to our church for a long time.
他都跟老婆来听道理。
And then he accompanied his wife.
他常常跟老婆说，你多听一点。
And then he always tell his wife, hear more truth.
这个信主很好，你要多去聚会。
It is wonderful to listen to the sermons. Go to church more often.
甚至他有时候老婆懒了，他会说：“你今天要去聚会，怎么还在睡觉？”
And sometimes the wife becomes lazy. He will actually remind his wife, "How come you're not going to church today?"
有时候他自己也会懒。
And sometimes he will come to church himself.
但是他就不敢洗礼。
But yet he just is reluctant to get baptized.
为什么？
Why?
人家问他为什么你不洗礼？
So other people ask him, why don't you get baptized?
传道我洗礼就不能骗人了，我做生意怎么可能不骗人？
And then he says that, preacher, you know, I'm a businessman. If I get baptized, and I cannot cheat. But I'm a businessman, you know. I have to make business.
我很多坏习惯，我一洗了礼就说很多坏事不能做了。
And I have so many bad habits. Once I get baptized, I cannot do them no more.
所以他说，哇，不想洗礼，不想信。
So therefore, he's reluctant to get baptized.
他觉得信了就很没有自由。
Because his mentality is such that once he get baptized, he lose all freedom.
大概他想好了，等我断气之前，大概三五天我就洗礼，那就赚到了。之前我还可以很自由，到最后几天没自由。
So he must be telling to himself, well, at least now I can enjoy all the freedom I have until the last few days of my life. That's the time when I will get baptized.
哇，太会算了。
He knows how to calculate his life.
真的是这样吗？
So is that really true?
他想了完全错了。
But his thinking is really downright wrong.
神的话不是绑住了，让你没自由。
Because God's word is not to bind you so that you lose all kind of freedom.
神的话语是让你得到真自由。
But rather, God's word is to give you true liberty.
我们看约翰福音。Let's
turn to the Gospel of John.
我们看约翰福音的第六章。
Gospel of John, chapter 6.
我们看第八章。
Chapter 8.
八章32节。
Chapter 8, verse 32.
约翰福音八章的32节。
John 8:32.
八章32节一起读。
Let's read it out loud.
一二三。 你们必然晓得真理，真理必叫你们得以自由啊！ 哇，这句话太宝贵了。
So this verse is so precious.
有真自由，就是有假自由了。
So what does that mean? If there is true freedom, that means there's also false freedom.
什么叫假自由？
What is false freedom?
人以为的自由就是假自由。So
false freedom are the freedom that are man-made.
假自由就是以为我想做什么我都可以做什么，就是自由。
False freedom are the worldly thinking that I can just do whatever I desire and please.
我想抽烟就抽烟，我想赌博就赌博，我想看色情就看色情，这个是不是很自由啊？
Because it is my desire. If I want to smoke, I smoke. If I want to gamble or watch pornography, it is my freedom.
这个是真自由吗？
So is that true freedom?
你一抽了烟，你上瘾了，你停得了吗？
Because once you smoke a cigarette, you get addicted. Can you stop yourself?
你吸毒了。
Now you take drugs.
你戒得了吗？
Can you just cut it right away?
你酗酒了，你停得了吗？
And if you're addicted to alcohol, can you just drop it?
其实你被那些东西一绑住，你就没自由了。
In fact, if you are being bound by all this substance abuse, you lose your freedom.
多少钱你都要买。
No, doesn't matter how much money you pour into it, you still have to give in.
伤害自己身体的，你也要做。
And what hurts your body, you still go ahead.
破坏自己家庭的事情，你也停止不了。
And what breaks up your family, you cannot even stop it.
你是被欲望捆绑。
Because you are being bound by your evil desires.
全世界都是被恶者、被魔鬼捆绑住。
And this whole world is being bound by the evil of the devil.
但是魔鬼很厉害，魔鬼让他们觉得他们很自由。
But the devil is very, very smart. He allowed these people to think that they are free.
就好像人家监牢里面觉得，监牢里面有免费的食物，又有暖气。 啊，又有免费的水，又不用上班，都有饭吃，多好啊！
And just like what people are thinking, well, if I were to live in the prison, it's so wonderful. I get free food, I get free space, I don't have to pay rent.
哇，还不用缴税？你在外面工作还要缴税，我在监牢里面免费吃饭，不用缴税。
And that I don't even have to pay tax in the prison. People who work out there, they have to pay tax to the government.
你这样想，他们是不是比你们还好？
So if you think that this way, then living in the prison is so great.
这个是骗人的。
But of course, you are being deceived.
你活在监牢里面哪有自由？
So if you are living in the prison, what kind of freedom are you talking about?
那我们今天也是一样。
So today, in the same way, we are just like people.
不要被骗了。
That are being cheated.
主耶稣说，你们一定要晓得真理。
So Lord Jesus says that you must know the truth.
主耶稣本身就是真理。
Because Lord Jesus Himself is the truth.
他会给我们真自由。
And that this truth will give you true freedom.
你真正认识耶稣。
Because you truly come to know Jesus.
真正接受真理。
And that you truly accept the truth.
那就有力量跟那些过去的坏习惯说拜拜了。
Then you will have the strength to say goodbye to all the bad habits of the past.
以前一直抽，一直抽停不了了。
And in the past, you keep smoking cigarette, you just can't stop.
祷告靠主，把它戒掉。
So you pray and rely on God to help you cut this habit.
我不需要那些东西。
I don't need all this cigarettes.
你沉迷这个酒精或者赌博。
And maybe you're addicted to alcohol or gambling.
或是网络色情。
Or pornography on the internet.
你祷告，你靠着神。
So pray and rely upon God.
那你心中的空虚呢？用神的话去填满。
And use the word of God to fill up the void of your heart.
常常听道理，亲近神。
And you always listen to the truth, always draw close to God.
你对那些不好的欲望就慢慢的远离了。
And then you will become further and further away from all the evil desires.
慢慢你就不需要它了。
And then slowly over time, you don't need them anymore.
不是不可以，而是不需要了。
And it's not because you are bound to them, it's because you don't need them anymore.
你已经满足了嘛。
Because you're already satisfied.
其实很多那些所谓的坏习惯，都是因为人心里很虚空产生的。
So in fact, a lot of the substance abuse came about because of the emptiness of the heart.
你看那些大明星啊。 有名人啊，很多都是暗中吸毒啦，还有在做一些不好的事情。
And if you look at all the celebrities, some of them, they are addicted to a lot of substance abuse in the dark.
心中太空了。
Because their heart is so empty.
已经得到成功了，还有什么好追求的？
So because they've already received fame and success, what else is there to strive for?
反而去被那些东西绑住。
So then now they turn around and get bound by all this substance abuse.
所以神的话要释放我们。
So that is why we need to come back to the word of God. It will make us free.
但是你要先让神的话稍微绑一下下。
So at first you may be bound by the truth for a while.
没有错，神的话会规范你。
It is true. The word of God will straighten you up.
好像你失去一点点自由。
It seems like you have lost a little bit of freedom. But in fact, the word of God is giving you the utmost freedom. That is to say, you must first lose some false freedom in order to gain the true freedom.
哇，这个是不容易，你要想通，要靠着主。
And definitely, this is not easy to achieve. You must break through your thinking and that to realize that is the truth.
所以神的话语是生命。
Because the word of God is true.
啊, 再来另外一节圣经很重要。
And then there's another verse that is very important.
希伯来书第四章。
Let's turn to the book of Hebrews chapter 4.
希伯来第四章的十二节。
Hebrews chapter 4 verse 12.
希伯来书第四章十二节。
Hebrews 4 verse 12.
啊，这句话也要画下来，记下来，非常重要。
And this is also a very important verse. Please underline this.
希伯来四章十二节。
Hebrews 4 verse 12. Let's read it.
神的道
For the word of God is living and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword,
更快,
piercing even to the division of soul and spirit and of joints and marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart.
哇, 这里说神的话语啊, 不单只要成为我们的准则, 神的话语还要修理我们。
So over here it says that the word of God is not just the standard of our Christian living, it will also straighten us up.
就说神的话是什么?
Here it says that what is the word of God?
神的话是活泼的。
Here it says that the word of God is living.
原文就是有生命的意思,活着的不是死的。
In the original text, it means that the word of God is alive, it is not dead.
东西有生命没生命差很远。
So whether it is alive or dead, there is a big difference.
有些东西很漂亮,但是它是假的。
Some things are very beautiful, but it is artificial.
但塑胶花,它很漂亮。
For example, artificial flowers, yes, it's very lovely.
但是它没有生命。
But it has no life.
它永远就是这个样子。
It remains its look forever in the same plastic way.
但是有生命的花,它会开,开完之后凋谢,它有根的话,它明年还会再开。
But for a flower that is true and living in the garden, when it's wilted, it will grow again next year.
还有呢,每次看它那个样子都不一样。
And every time you behold the flower, each time is so different.
你看一本书啊,外面的书啊,你看一次,你看第二次就没有什么味道,因为你的知道里面讲什么。
And the same way, when you read any book out there, you read it once and that's enough. You won't read it the second time.
这时候你看过两次了,你不会看十次。
And even though you may read it at most twice, you won't read it 10 times.
因为它没生命,它是人的书。
Because it has no life, it is written by man.
它的,比如说小说,写得再好看,你也不会去看它十次。
So take for example a novel, no matter how good it is, you read it once and you're done.
你也不会说每个字去研究它。
And you won't study word by word and read it 10 times.
那我看完就算了。
And once I read it, and I'm done with it.
这是神的话不一样哦。
But the Bible, the Word of God, is different.
神的话是有生命，它本身就是生命。
The Word of God is life; itself carries life.
哎，你年轻的时候看它没什么感觉。
So when you're young, when you read the Bible, you may not feel anything.
当你中年的时候，活到中年的时候再看同一个记载，哎，你开始领悟多一点。
And when you enter middle age, you read it, you may have some kind of reflection.
到了老年的时候，你再看，哇，完全感觉又不一样。
And then in your senior years, when you read the same verse again, you will have a different kind of reflection.
哦，你开心的时候看它，有不同的感觉。
And when you're joyful, when you read it, it gives you a different sense of feeling.
遇到人生很挫折的时候看它，哎，要给你不一样的安慰。
And the same verse can give you a different level of comfort when you meet trials in life.
就像你看那个风景啊，这个树啊，这个山啊，这些鸟啊，这个生命有生命的东西一直在变化。
And just like when you look at the natural world, the mountains, the birds, the skies, they are constantly changing because they carry life.
神的话语这样子，它内容不变，但是它对你的影响力一直随着你的需要来调整，来帮助你。
Yes, the word of God doesn't change, but it is according to your needs at different stages of your life that it will fulfill you.
哇，这种 dynamic 啊，这种有活力的、有生命力在里面。
And that is to say, the words of God carry a certain dynamics. It is so spiritual.
还有呢，这里说神的话是有功效的。
And over here it says that the word of God it carries great function.
哎，为什么这里用什么来东西来比喻神的话语？
So what kind of analogy does it compare to?
这里说用一把两刃的利剑来表喻神的话语。
So over here, the word of God is likened to a double-edged sword.
什么叫两刃的剑？
What is a double-edged sword?
两边都是锋利的，两边都可以切割的。
Double-edged sword means that it is sharpened on both sides of the blade.
不是只有一边哦，两边都可以了。It's
not just one side of the blade that is sharpened; it is on both sides.
什么意思？
What does that mean?
神的话语常常都有一举两面的双面的功用。
And that is to say, the double-edged sword of God, it will pierce through you, carrying two different kind of functions.
神的话语可以安慰你。
Because the word of God can comfort you,
在你伤心的时候可以安慰,
especially when you're sad and downtrodden.
但是神的话语也会责备你,
but also the word of God will correct you.
责备你,
it will rebuke you.
你做得不好, 你怎么可以这样子? 诶, 神的话语读到的时候好像刀子割进去, 有时候很难受耶。
And the word of God will rebuke you. Sometimes it feels like a sword being pierced into your heart, you feel so bad.
我们不要挑那个福气啊恩典啊挑那个来读啊，有些人喜欢挑圣经来读。
And so some people, they are very selective in their Bible reading. They only want to read the words of blessing.
读圣经或者听到不是吃buffet。
So when you read the Bible or study Bible, you're not taking a buffet.
什么叫吃buffet? 吃自助餐。
What does it mean to have a buffet?
哎，这个肉我喜欢。
Oh, I like this meat.
有人吃 buffet 什么不吃？吃那个虾子一大盘，哇，五六十只。他说要回本。Some
people they go to buffet, they don't touch anything but just the prawns.
哇，生鱼片，整堆生鱼片。Or
just the raw fish, the sashimi.
自挑自己喜欢的这一大盘，自己不喜欢的看都不看。And
they will fill their plates full with these food that they desire. They will just neglect all the rest.
你这样吃啊，长期这样吃会吃死自己啊。And
so if you eat it in this way, then you'll bring death upon yourself.
神的话语双刃的利剑。The
word of God, it is a double-edged sword.
有时候你读了，哎呀，安慰你，感谢主。So
thank God, sometimes when you read the Bible, it comforts you.
但是有时候骂你啊，你怎么可以那么的顽固？这是讲你，这是讲你自己。
But sometimes the Bible rebuke you. How come you're so stubborn? It's actually pointing you out.
如果我们读圣经，听到不觉得这个是讲我们自己。
So if we read the Bible, we listen to the sermon, and we don't feel that it is talking about us.
那就白听了，你就浪费了时间了。
Then you're just wasting your time.
我们听到读经的时候，要感觉到神在对我讲话，因为这是神的生命来的。So
that is to say, when you listen to the sermon and studying the Bible, remember it is pointing to you yourself.
还有呢，这把刀很利哦，这手术刀哎。And
remember this sword, it is very sharp. It's sharper than just like it's like a surgical blade.
它是比全世界的刀更利更快。And
it is sharper than any blade out there.
听说以前中国有一个古剑，哇，那个。 越王勾践的那个宝剑，非常的锋利，找到了，那个已经找到了，有一把宝剑。So
it goes to say that there is a certain very famous sword in antiquity in
中国
in China
春秋战国时代的
in China and
越王勾践，and
that they have found this blade through the archaeological discovery.
几千年前就可以造到一把非常锋利的宝剑。And
that is to say, several thousands years ago, they can actually manufacture such a sharp blade.
以前的形容是削铁如泥，好像削那个铁，好像削泥一样，把它烧掉。
And then they can just use the sword and cut anything like just slicing a dust.
或者你头发掉进去，自动会剖开两边。They
can it can actually just cut through a strand of hair.
哇，这个是很快很利的宝剑。That
is to say that sword is very sharp and very swift.
但是圣经神的话语比一切最厉害的宝剑还快还锋利。But
yet the word of God it is sharper and even more swift than any sword out there.
它要砍什么呢？
So what does this sword, what is it trying to cut?
它不是砍石头，不是砍树。
It's not going to cut any tree down or any stone.
它要砍你的灵魂啊。
This sword is going to pierce your soul.
魂与灵，把它剖开了。
It will pierce even to the division of soul and spirit.
我们知道我们现在看到的就是你的肉体嘛，你跟我的肉体，最表面那层皮啊。
And now, of course, when you look at one another, we're just looking at the most outer skin of every person.
你心里面想什么，别人不知道。
What are you thinking in your heart? No one knows.
神知道啊。
But God knows.
你在听道理的时候，神的话语，其实讲到的人不是在讲你，你不要骂他。
Because the word of God, remember, the sermon speaker is not actually scolding you. Don't scold the sermon speaker.
神的仆人，讲道的人不会特别准备一篇道理来讲某一个人，没有的，没有这种事的。
Because the sermon speaker or any preacher, they are not preparing a sermon just for you alone.
圣经讲什么，写什么，他们就讲什么。
Because whatever the Bible says, that is what they preach.
神感动他们讲什么，他就讲什么。
So whatever God's Spirit will to move the servant of God, that is what the servant of God will preach.
或是有时候你打开圣经，你刚好今天读到这一段。
Sometimes you open up the Bible and you fallen onto a certain paragraph.
或是你在网络上面随便按一篇道理，诶，就是讲道理啊。
And then, or perhaps you just turn on the internet and listen to a sermon online.
讲道理，你不要生气。
So if you hear the sermon and you feel like it's pointing at you, do not be angry.
是神的道要帮你动手术啊。
Because the word of God is performing a surgery upon your heart.
把你的里面的灵破开啊。
And the word of God is going to divide your soul and your spirit. To divide your soul and spirit.
为什么？
Why is that so?
因为里面长癌症啊。
Because you have a tumor, cancerous. You have a cancerous tumor in you.
你心里面的苦毒。
And that is that spiritual tumor inside your heart.
心里面的罪。
Your sin inside your heart.
里面的骄傲。
Your pride inside your heart.
我们人都会保持得很好，别人看不见。
And of course, on the outside, we'll maintain a certain level of wellness.
客客气气。
No one can see.
客客气气的。
And we are very hospitable.
哈利路亚，平安，感谢主。
We say hallelujah, peace to you, praise the Lord.
我们都很会演，知道来教会要演什么。
We are such good actors and actresses. We know how to perform in the church.
但是里面呢？里面长怎么样呢？
But what is really inside you, deep down?
如果愿意神的话进来。
So if you allow the word of God to enter into
your heart,
once it pierces yourself through,
太多肿瘤了，太多毒了。
You have too many poison tumors, cell inside your heart.
还有了有一些不好的思念。
And also you have some bad thoughts.
哎，神的话语会帮你辨明，哎，这个不对。
The word of God will help you to discern that your thoughts are not right.
你常常读神的话，你就比较一下自己的思想，你就知道，哎，原来我这个思想跟神的话是不符合的。
Because if you always study the word of God, you will realize that your thoughts are going astray from His word.
哦，因为呢，神要把我们剖开。
Because God's word is going to pierce us and divide our spirit and soul.
我们读十三节。
Let's look at verse 13 together.
大声读十三节啊！一二三。并且被造的没有一样在他面前不显的，原来万物在那与我们有关的主面前都是赤露敞开的。原来神用他的话语让我们打开了。
So God is using His word to open up our heart.
那我们自己也要知道自己被打开了。
So we must also know that our heart has been divided.
那既然已经被主耶稣打开了，就承认吗？
So since our heart has been opened, we must come to the realization.
主啊，你的话语天天帮我开刀。
That, oh Lord, your word is performing a surgery on me every day.
把你不喜欢的东西拿走。
And to take away all the things that you do not like.
把你不喜欢的意念拿走。
And to take away all the evil intents and thoughts of my heart.
这样我们才能达到，慢慢达到主耶稣的标准。
So as we discern our thoughts and intents of our heart, we will reach His standard.
这样以后才能进天国啊。
Then in future, we can enter into the heavenly kingdom.
大家想一想。
So think about this.
神会容许一些不像耶稣的人进天国吗？
So will God allow people who does not carry the image of Jesus into heaven?
你说你受洗了。
Take for example, you're baptized.
你长得不像耶稣。
But you don't look like Lord Jesus.
心思意念不像耶稣。
Your heart and your intent of your desire are not like Jesus.
行为。
Your conduct.
还有我们的思想。
And your thoughts.
所以我们要真的要靠着主。
So we must really rely upon God's power.
基本信仰第二条。
And the second article of our basic belief,
不但只是信圣经是神的话,
not just believe that the Bible is the only scriptural truth,
我们要相信这个是生命,
we must believe that the Holy Bible is the life of God.
这是神的生命,
it is the life of God.
这个也要改变我们的生命,
it is the one that will change our lives.
愿主帮助我们,
may God help us.
唱诗,
let's sing him.
25.
Let's sing him 25.